I'm going to show you how to make a 3D logo get its spin on using PowerDirector. Let's get dizzy. We'll start off by creating a title. So we want to go up to the title room. And we're going to go ahead and go to the default 3D title. We'll hold on our left mouse button and we'll drag it down to the beginning of track one. Now I want this title to be a bit longer, so I'm going to click on duration. And I'm going to change this to 10 seconds. And I'll click on OK. Now we'll go ahead and click on the designer button to open up the title designer. We'll double click in a text box with our left mouse button. And we're going to go ahead and change the font type. And we're going to choose good old Wingdings. Now we're going to go up to the title box here. We're going to highlight the text and we're going to type the letter N in our keyboard and it creates a square. Now we'll go ahead and double click in the text box and we're going to change the font to size. And we're going to make this 96 to make it nice and big. And then we'll go ahead and drag this over to the center position. So now we're going to close the font paragraph setting. And we're going to open up the font face setting. Here we're going to go ahead and change the extrusion. So I'm going to double left click in this box. And then I'm going to move the extrusion up. And we'll move it to 50. And then we're going to go ahead and close the font face. We'll open the 3D rotation settings. And you can play around with the settings to get what you want. I'm going to go ahead and use the setting that I want here. And if you want to copy my settings, you got them right here. Go ahead and copy them. If you don't, make it the settings that you need. Now I'm going to go ahead and close all the 3D rotation settings. And we want to go ahead and use the 3D texture settings. If you don't have that open, just click on it and open it up. And now we want to go ahead and add our own texture. So we're going to click on add texture. And then you want to go to the location on your device where the logo is. Click on that logo. And then click on open. Now you want to go ahead and left click on the selected logo. And you can go ahead and close the 3D texture settings now. Then you want to go to the animation tab. And we want to choose in animation. And we want to scroll down until we come to 3D spin horizontal 1. And we see it here. We'll go ahead and left click on it. And it gives a quick preview of what it's going to do. Now, if you go ahead and move your scrubber on the timeline, you'll see that it spins and then it stops there. We want it to spin the whole time. So what we'll do is we'll place our cursor over the out effect. We'll left click on it and we'll drag it all the way to the right. And then we'll do the same thing here. We'll go ahead and click on the end of the in animation. Hold on our left mouse button and drag it all the way over. And now if we scrub the timeline, you'll see that it spins the entire time. It spins slower as well, which gives it a better look. So now we'll go ahead and click on OK. Let's play this. That'll add some much needed flair to your intros, graphics, and anywhere else that you want to use this logo. You can use titles to make all kinds of goodness for any video, and you can learn more by watching this playlist of title tutorials. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.